I'm going to ask everyone to stand and repeat after me. I was glad when they said unto me.
I was glad when they said unto me.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
All ye lands.
All ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Come before his presence with singing.
Come before his presence with singing.
We're going to ask you to remain standing as we're led in prayer by Deacon Rodney Moore.
Amen. Let us bow our heads. Father God, we thank you and give you the most high honor and most high praise. Lord, we thank you for just getting each and every one of us here safely, Lord, to be able to worship in your name, Lord. We thank you for how you just continue to bless our bishop down throughout the week, giving him the strength and power he needs to give us your word, Lord, which is our food, God. We thank you for our deacons, our missionaries, saints, the mother of the church, Lord. We ask you to touch those that can't be here right now, Lord, but wherever they are, get them into the mood and the spirit, Lord. We ask you to touch those that may be on their way here. But most of all, Lord, we thank you for your son, Jesus, and let us have a wonderful time in your name today. We pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And today's scripture is coming from Psalm, the 3rd chapter, verses 3 through 8, and this is the New International Version. But you, Lord, are a shield around me, my glory, the one who lifts my head high. I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again, because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Arise, Lord, deliver me, my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked.
Yes.
From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessing be on your people. Amen. May God have a blessing upon the word.
Amen. We thank God for being in his service once again. Truly, we thank God for his continual blessings on our life. We know without him, we would not be where we are. With all the tribulations and the trials that we face, we know it is God who fights our battles. And we are a winner because he surrounds us.
Amen.
I'm so
the Lord today.
Hallelujah.
Not only do I need it, I want it.
Amen.
And it's mine. Because he said, anything that you ask in my name, I am able to provide.
Amen.
If you want it, if you need it, it's yours. I don't know about you, but I came to get mine today.
We'll be right back.
I I'm not one of those preachers who feel they are the only ones who have the word from the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus.
No, there are many Holy Ghost filled preachers that are delivering the true word of God.
Amen.
Via social media.
Amen.
And I can tell you, I enjoy watching them.
Yeah.
I try to watch as many as I can. Therefore, again, I want to say to those that have taken out the time to watch our videos, thank you.
Thank you.
Amen.
And I pray that something is being said and done that God is pleased with.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
And that you are being edified about our great God.
Amen.
And our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
I want to start today's message by stating that God loves you.
Yes.
I want everybody in here to know. Everybody that's watching via social media, that God loves you.
Hallelujah. Yes.
For if you believe the Holy Bible is the infallible, written word of God, you should know without a shadow of doubt that God loves you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
For John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But I want you to always remember what I preached several weeks ago. That it is not God's love for you, but it is your love for him that will determine your final destiny.
Amen.
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 Now someone may ask, what is the final destiny? Well, again, if you believe the Holy Bible, it's the true word of God. Then the final destiny for everyone is life or death.
Amen. Amen.
In other words, heaven or hell.
Amen. Jesus, right.
Now I know this day and time is not fashionable to say the word hell. Unless you are cursing somebody out.
Yeah.
You're cursing somebody out. You can say from now. Till you get tired of saying.
Yeah.
And everybody be fine with it.
Yeah.
But when you use that word in church, people become concerned. Why are you using that word?
Man.
But when I say hell, I'm talking about a place as stated in the book of Revelations 20:14-15. And death and hell,
all right,
in this incident, the word hell means the grave. Were cast into the lake of fire.
Amen.
In this incident, the lake of fire is hell.
Amen.
Lord,
this is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
Come on now.
Hell.
Come
one may say, and this is horrible.
Here you go.
Horrible.
Yeah.
Why would God create such a terrible place like this for people to go to?
Come on.
Well, the first thing you need to know is that this place was not created for human beings.
Amen.
See, when people ask a question, the answer's in the Word.
Sure is. Yes, it is.
Let me say that again. This place, hell, God never created for human beings.
Amen.
Come on now.
What do you mean, Pastor? Well, Jesus said in Matthew 25, the 41st verse. Then shall he say also unto them on the left.
Come on now.
On the left hand.
Lord.
Depart from me. Ye cursed. Into everlasting fire. Prepare for the devil and his angels. So this clearly tells us, this is written in God's word,
come on,
that hell was not created for us, but for the devil and those angels that follow him.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
Those angels that followed him.
Keep going.
And if you choose to follow the devil,
amen,
you just like those angels.
Amen. Right.
And you're going to go where those angels, along with the devil, are going.
Amen.
A place where you're not invited.
Right.
A place that was not prepared for you. A place that God had no intentions of human beings going.
Right.
He's right.
So true.
Well, I told you God loves us.
Yes.
Amen.
And this is why God sent Jesus to save us from this place.
Amen.
Jesus came. That's why he came.
Amen.
He didn't come to make us rich.
No.
Keep going.
He didn't come to give us houses.
No.
Cars.
No.
Make us a millionaire.
Keep going. Don't come for that.
He came to save us.
Yeah.
From our sins. Because the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Come on.
You don't have to go to this place.
No.
But if anyone goes, the blame is on you.
Yes.
Right now.
Amen.
Why? Because God has provided a way for us to escape it.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
Keep going.
And that way is through Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
And this will happen when Jesus returns.
Yes. Amen. Come on.
And unfortunately, in a lot of churches today, and this is not being preached.
Amen.
Yep. Keep going.
Preaching everything else.
We're preaching now, Bishop.
Yeah.
Amen.
Everything else.
Speaking the truth.
Except for the reason that Jesus came.
Lord.
The way he suffered.
Come on.
Talked about. Lied on.
Come on.
Lord.
They spit on him.
Come on.
Whipped him.
Yeah.
Jesus. Oh.
They nailed him to a cross.
Uh-huh.
My Lord.
And he died. Why would you think God would allow his son to come here in this world and be handled like that if God didn't want to spare mankind from something horrible?
Why?
Amen.
Huh?
Yes.
Yes, hell is horrible.
Yes.
That's why God does not want us to go.
Right.
Amen.
Help me, Jesus.
Come on.
Help me.
He has made it possible.
Yes.
That nobody has to go.
That's right.
Can I be a witness?
Yes!
Come on.
Right.
Yes. Amen.
And this is a problem. Mm-hmm. A major problem in the world today.
Uh-huh.
Many people are focusing on everything except what really matters.
Yes.
You know what really matters?
Uh-huh.
It's the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Lord.
Amen.
I listen to some of these preachers and let me tell you right now, I'm 100% for prosperity. I'm 100% for our young people getting the best education they can. Get a great job. Make as much money as you can. Have a nice house. But when it all said and done, what really matters is what God did for us through Jesus Christ. Why did God do it? Because he loves you. I go back again to saying God proved his love for everybody. God had to sit in heaven and watch his son be mistreated.
Uh-huh.
Some of you parents can get upset if somebody, you feel as though somebody mistreated your child.
Right. Yeah.
You ready to hit the streets.
Uh-huh.
Your whole conscience changes.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
What do you think about God?
Lord.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
He had to watch that.
Lord.
But he did it because he loves us. He's done more than we can ever expect him to do.
Hallelujah.
That's why I love that old song, what more can he do?
No more can he do, Lord.
What more?
What more?
They don't sing that anymore. Young people don't even know that song. But the lyrics are, what more can he do?
Come on.
He done laid the foundation.
Right.
And opened up the way.
Uh-huh.
I love
that.
Huh?
Yeah. We won't sing that, but that's one of our old traditional songs.
Yeah.
And the saints will get happy.
Happy.
Because they know God did it.
Come on now.
Yes, yes.
Through Jesus Christ.
Oh, yes.
And I said what really matters to everybody. Go as far as you can in life.
All right. What?
But as I said a moment ago, what really matters is the second coming of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
And because Jesus has not returned in over 2,000 years since he departed, since his departure from this world, and many people believe it's not going to happen.
Right.
That's so.
Y'all hear what I said?
Yeah.
Lord.
Many people believe.
Yeah.
You can look at attitudes of all people in our own family.
Yeah.
I won't bother my own family.
Come on now.
You don't know how hard I'm praying for them.
Yeah, I do.
I'm praying for everybody.
Yeah.
Because if you really believe what I just read about hell, and you know the only way not to go is through Jesus Christ. If you really believe it, and you don't want to go, you'll be running to Jesus.
Amen.
Play around, that's for sure.
Huh? You be running to Jesus.
Yes.
Come on.
But there's so many believe he's not coming.
Yes.
And you know what I want you to know? This is nothing new.
Amen.
This is nothing new. This is nothing new. I want Sister Johnson to read.
Amen.
Nothing new.
Uh-uh.
Read, Sister Johnson.
2 Peter 3, chapter 3, verses 3, 4, 8, 9, and 10.
Amen.
And this is the King James Version. Knowing this verse, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lust.
Scoffers. You know what the definition of scoffers are? Mockers.
Lord.
They don't believe.
Don't believe.
And they'll down ye.
Yes.
And talk about you.
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Yeah.
Lord.
Why are you believing that crap?
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
This was in the Bible days. And Peter is talking to the church.
Come on.
Huh?
Amen.
Not too long after Jesus had gone back home.
Uh-huh.
And there were scoffers then, mockers then.
Uh-huh.
Read, Sister Johnson.
And say, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation.
They were saying. They were saying. Just what we're hearing now. Y'all been talking about that for years. Talking about that for years.
Come on.
That Jesus is coming back.
Right.
In the Bible days, they were saying,
yes.
Where is he?
Uh-huh.
Where is he?
Uh-huh.
You all been saying he's coming back. That's all we've been hearing.
Yeah.
Our late pastor's gone home to be with the Lord.
Yeah.
He preached there for years. He gone home.
Uh-huh.
We still here.
Yes.
And Jesus has not returned. You got scoffers in the church.
Yeah.
Dude. Huh? They may not physically say it.
Uh-huh.
But you know what gives them away?
Uh-huh.
They're at you.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Your behavior.
Your behavior.
Your character.
Uh-huh.
Because if you really believe that Jesus can come anytime, you will make sure you're right.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's it.
No fear or nobody will get in your way.
Uh-huh.
No.
Look at the churches now, people are so slowful.
Yes. Yeah.
Lord.
And now their teaching is changing. The church now is trying to accommodate young people.
Uh-huh.
I don't mind accommodating young people.
Uh-huh.
I know things have got to change.
Right.
And some of us old folks don't believe in change.
Uh-huh.
Change is not a bad thing.
No.
Change is a good thing.
Yes.
Amen.
You only get mad at change when it affects us.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yep.
Man.
Change it.
Uh-huh.
Just don't let it affect me.
That's right. Yeah.
We don't do the things we used to do
uh-huh.
with the former generation.
All right.
No,
now.
We don't.
You're right.
We're not singing bringing in the sheaves.
All
right
now.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
I don't mind changing with the time uh-huh. because you have to do that.
Yes.
Lord.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Come on.
But one thing that will never change is the Word of God.
Amen, Bishop.
I want these young people to get involved.
Yes.
I want them to do things.
Uh-huh.
But most important, I want them saved.
Saved.
I want them to get to know Jesus.
Yes.
I want them to appreciate
uh-huh.
what God has done for them
yes.
through Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Yes, come as you are.
Uh-huh.
But when you come as you are, make a change.
Yes, I like that, Bishop.
But what I love about young people now is looking for churches that would accommodate
Yes.
what they want to do. What they want to do is continue in sin.
Yes, in sin.
Continue in sin.
Yes.
Continue in sin. And sing them, jump, holler, skip. Skip to money around the church. And they feel as old folks now are beyond the times.
Yes.
And preachers are on, some of them are on Facebook and YouTube telling the old preachers, you too far behind the times, you're going to lose your young people. Let me tell you right now, before I tell you a lie, walk out the door.
Amen.
So what is a lie going to do for you?
Amen.
What is a lie going to do for anybody?
Amen.
I don't care where any of y'all go.
Yes.
You know the truth.
That's right.
Yep. You got it.
That's the bottom line.
You know some things can't come here.
Right.
Right.
That's the bottom.
I love everybody. God, I just told you God loves you.
God loves
you.
Amen.
But they know there's certain things we can't allow in here.
No.
Right. So they're not coming here.
Right.
Right.
If they don't want to change.
That's right.
Now I respect you.
Yes.
I'm going to still love you.
Right.
I'm going to still pray for you.
Yeah.
And you can go wherever you want to go.
Uh-huh.
You know the truth.
You know the truth.
The answer is in the Word.
Uh-huh.
It's in the Word.
And when we're trying to attract our young people, yes, things can change and things will change.
Uh-huh.
But the Word of God will never change.
Never.
Amen.
Never.
Amen.
Never.
Huh? Uh-huh.
You got young people now trying to change the definition of words.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
It don't mean that.
Uh-huh.
Now we're changing definition of words.
All right.
Wow.
And that's what we doing now?
Oh,
no,
not me, Bishop.
Look up the word fornication.
Uh-huh.
Because this is a problem with our young people.
Yes.
And the old people too.
Yeah.
Old people. Amen. This is a major problem in the church.
Yes.
Yeah.
And preachers won't teach you.
Uh-huh.
They will not preach.
Because if you are going to accept Jesus and follow Jesus, you cannot do it.
Right.
I'm not going to tell those young people they can do that.
Right.
No.
You might be doing it, but you ain't getting no proof from me.
Right.
Like a preacher was being interviewed.
Uh-huh.
By a radio announcer.
Uh-huh.
Well-known preacher.
Uh-huh.
Come on.
He made the comment, if I'm talking to a 16-year-old boy, I'll tell that 16-year-old boy to be celibate.
Uh-huh.
But if I'm talking to a single man, 37 years old, I got to come with something different.
Because
that's not relevant for somebody 37-year-old to think they're going to be celibate.
Wow.
A single man.
Uh-huh.
What were you saying about a single woman?
That's right.
Right.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Amen.
And now, fornication for him and these young people means as long as you are in a committed relationship. That's what marriage means for them now. As long as you're in a committed relationship, that's what it means. That's what the Bible's talking about. Well, first thing, the definition of fornication for you dummies.
All right.
Because I'll come at you. You start messing with God's word. You're not going to agree with it. Leave it alone. Don't try to change it to suit your lifestyle.
Right.
Amen.
You show me that in the Bible, then I got to preach it.
Yeah.
Not in there.
Pick up a Western dictionary. And the definition of fornication is sexual relationship outside of marriage.
Specify.
Read the Bible.
Uh-huh.
That's why the Bible said marriage is honorable.
Uh-huh.
And the bed is undefiled.
Right.
Read it.
Distinction.
Huh?
Right.
Uh-huh.
But you're going to say what you feel.
Yeah, right.
I feel.
It's not about what you feel.
that marriage now does not mean getting legally married. As long as you're in a committed relationship. You know the problem with that? You can say you're in a committed relationship today with somebody.
Right.
And having sex.
Right.
And then when you finish, it's over.
That's right.
That's right.
I'm moving on to somebody else.
That's right.
Now I'm in a committed relationship with you.
Right.
Huh?
Yes.
Bring them on the stop.
Right. They won't, Bishop.
Let me tell you about our generation.
Right.
We messed up too.
Yes, we did.
Right in the church.
Speaking the truth.
We sinned too.
Yes.
Right in the church. Fornication was going on right in the church.
Yes.
But the preacher still preached the truth.
Yes, he did.
Huh?
Right.
And we didn't try to change the word to suit our lifestyle.
No, we didn't. No, we
did. Can I get a witness?
Yes.
That's the difference now.
What did I say about homosexuality? Ain't nothing new.
Right.
Huh? It's wrong because the Bible said it's wrong.
Right.
Amen. You don't believe in the Bible, what you going to church for?
That's right.
Amen. You know what?
Amen.
Yeah, okay, Bishop.
Huh?
Yeah.
Why are you wasting your time if you're not going to believe in the Bible? What are you going there for?
Right.
To sing, dance, skip, and holler, and jump around.
Right.
Amen.
Yeah.
And if you told you're going to get rich.
Yeah.
You got a business coming.
Yeah.
I can see you're going to be a millionaire.
Yeah.
You're going to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
You look like a hair designer. You're going to soon have your own business.
Right.
Huh?
Yeah.
That's what's going on, Shirley.
Yes.
Jesus.
And that's what these young people are running behind.
Yeah.
Right. And then beyond the benediction. Huh? Everybody going out getting high.
Yeah.
And the problem is, yes, they did it like that. But we didn't try to change the word.
We didn't change that word.
We challenged it
either. We knew it was wrong.
Right.
And we kept coming.
Right.
Until the word of God got in us.
Right.
Amen.
And we knew we had to make a change. That's the definition of fornication.
Right.
And according to the Bible, marriage is between a man and a woman.
Yeah.
Right.
The Bible said, therefore, a man should leave his mother and father and cleave to his wife. And the two should become one flesh.
Right.
Amen.
I don't care what society says. Let them say what they want to say.
Right.
Let them do what they want to do. Right. What are you bringing that in the church for?
Right.
Why?
Lord.
This is nothing new.
No.
Why do you want to bring that into church?
Read your Bible.
Read.
And church getting all excited about what people are doing.
Right. Not me.
They've been doing it for years. Read your Bible.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to deviate it, but I had to. Because I'm trying to help y'all. Because some of y'all can get caught up in this.
Yeah.
You know why? Because some of y'all want to do these things.
Tell it.
Don't let nobody fool you.
Right.
Come on, man. Watch who's getting in your ear. Man, tell me that's not what the word of God means.
Right.
Come on.
All these years now, we've been having the wrong interpretation of what it means. We got the wrong interpretation of what adultery means.
Right.
Adultery, fornication, but somebody's marriage.
Right.
It means one person be married to somebody else.
Right. That's right.
You're both committing adultery. But yeah, people have been teaching you can only be, you only commit adultery if you're married. Read the definition.
Right.
The definition, it says adultery, relationship between two people and somebody. All they take is one person. When you're married to somebody else,
right.
You're both adulterers.
All right.
That makes sense.
And fornicators.
That makes sense to me.
Huh?
Yeah.
And we don't teach against sex.
Right.
God planned that.
Yeah.
And he know how he wanted it done.
Right.
If he hadn't done it his way, we would have all these sexual transmitted diseases.
That's right.
age.
Right.
You speaking.
Huh? You wrote the other ones.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Amen.
God was trying to spare us from this.
Right.
Always.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Amen.
And we got to tell our young people, no matter what they do, you know the truth.
You know the truth.
Watch out now.
We know social media. Now you can tap into anything.
Uh-huh.
Look at anything.
Anything you want.
We know y'all looking at it.
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Y'all ain't the only one looking at it.
Right.
You can't even get a good movie.
That's right.
Without a sex scene.
That's right.
Right there.
I don't know why God is sending you here, but whenever God does something for a reason.
Right.
Help somebody.
I remember my brother was telling me it was a joke.
Uh-huh.
He was telling me about a man. Mm. Something was going on. There was something they had to watch. Somebody had something to do with the law. Is that right there?
Yeah, he was watching.
And he was watching a tape.
Uh-huh.
A sex act. Because mm-hmm. it was part of the trial. Huh?
Uh-huh.
And he watching it. And they asked him, did you view the tape? Yes, I reviewed that disgusting tape 10 times. It was so disgusting. Why did you look at it 10 times? That's a good one. Let me get one more look.
That's what he said.
Huh?
That's what he said.
Yes, I had to look at it. I reviewed that disgusting tape 10 times. And when you saw it one time, it tickled your face.
Right.
Something got stirred up in you.
Yes.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
We are here with me. That's why one of the attributes of the Holy Ghost is self-control. We got to start preaching, you better get self-control.
Yes.
Because if you don't get self-control, you will be out of control.
Right.
Right, right in the church.
Right
there.
Huh? Y'all got a dance, I can talk to you.
Yes.
Somebody need to hear this.
I'm
on your side. People don't realize that. I tell people, you know you're not going to live holy.
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Come to church and keep your mouth closed.
Right.
Yes.
Like we did.
Right.
Y'all, I missed that.
Uh-huh.
Like we did.
I know.
Sat there and kept our mouths closed.
Yeah, you did.
We with it.
And heard the word of God.
Yes.
Shut up.
Come on.
And God rewarded us.
Yes.
Because he brought about a change. That's one of the major problems in the church.
Yeah.
Among the young and the old.
Man.
I dare not talk about multiple marriages.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to leave that alone.
All right.
Man.
Y'all, what we said up here, I've been married 10 times.
No.
And all my wives in the church.
Right.
All my 50 children in the church.
No.
I got a clan by myself.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Yeah.
One preacher keep going around here telling folk, because he got a divorce shiny. You know what he's telling people? God was jealous of his marriage. Huh? God wants you all to himself.
Oh my Lord.
This is the silly stuff that being on the end put on the internet. And I'm talking about preachers that people are watching.
Oh!
Huh? And they're young.
Young.
and say it's not good for man to be alone.
Right.
Jealous of your marriage?
Right.
Oh, no.
The God that said two shall become one.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
You jealous of your marriage?
No.
The God Jesus that styled the church as a marriage.
Yes.
Amen.
Jealous of your marriage?
I don't think
God broke up your marriage?
Uh-huh.
You broke it up.
Yes.
You broke it up by a friend right here cheating. And this is the stuff I'm trying to teach our young people. When you hear this stuff, click it off.
Right. You better click it off.
But you ain't strong enough.
No, you're not.
You better click it off.
You're not strong enough.
No, you're not.
You'll sit there and go along with this crap.
Uh-huh.
Why? Because you want to do it.
Yeah.
One thing somebody's telling this nonsense, it's another thing you hear people in the back like, amen.
Uh-huh.
I don't care what you say, somebody gonna yell, amen! Let's start worshiping this bottle of ketchup. Amen! Huh? Somebody gonna yell at amen.
Yeah.
And look at the hits.
That's right.
Look at the numbers.
Thousands.
Somebody watching.
Somebody watching.
And somebody agreeing with.
Yeah.
These are the times that we're living in.
Uh-huh.
And the preachers that are trying to hold on to the truth, they kick us off.
Uh-huh.
You're too old-fashioned.
Yeah.
I tell anybody, you show me in the Bible now where it's okay to have a friend
right
with benefits.
Uh-huh.
Pick up the Bible and show me that.
Right.
Because if you show me that, then I got to teach you.
Uh-huh.
Then I'm free to do it.
Yes.
Amen.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
They won't do that, but what they're doing now, they're telling you that's not what it means.
Uh-huh.
That's not what it means.
Uh-huh.
You're going to sit in a church with a pastor, a male pastor, and a first man?
Not me.
Huh? Church is a crowd.
Yeah.
Pastor and first man.
Yeah.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Women pastor and first lady.
Uh-huh. You
huh?
Right.
I'm not talking about people y'all don't know.
Pack
do your research.
Pack out. Yeah. Pack out.
Huh?
Pack out.
Yeah. Man,
one preacher told to put your church like that.
Uh-huh.
You know what he did, Jerry? He told the preacher, I came here to apologize for the church because we treated y'all so bad.
Lord.
I love what another preacher said. You don't speak for me.
Right now.
Just get it clear. You don't speak for me.
Right.
Huh? You're not gonna speak for me.
Right.
Come on.
I don't speak for me. I'm speaking what the word says.
Amen.
You got a problem with the word? And I'm talking about a preacher that got thousands of members. The same one I told you about told a 37-year-old man he wouldn't tell him now to be celibate. Now I guess you can't tell him that. You know why? Because you got about four children out of wedlock. Ain't married now. And came when he got a baby, about 2 years old.
Oh,
huh? This is what's going on.
Yeah.
In the church today.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Right.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
And the reason why it's going on is because we won't teach against it.
Amen.
Yeah. I ain't got no problem teaching against it. I don't care if you don't follow. Jesus for myself.
Amen.
You stop asking about you, you ask me about me.
Right.
Huh? That's why I tell people, don't get upset and worry yourself about what's going on. Why? These same people were back in the Bible then. We have been warned that this is going to happen before Jesus comes.
Broke
it down. And when we see these things happening, instead of us getting closer to Jesus, some of us running away.
Right. It worse.
Getting mad and upset by something silly.
Uh-huh. You speaking.
Silly.
Huh? When I see this thing going on, you know what I start saying? Help me, Jesus. Because Jesus said it's going to happen.
Right.
He said it's going to happen. Some folks fight in the church.
Amen.
We have seen it happen in this church.
Yes.
And I got news for you. It's not finished yet.
No.
Right. Sometimes the one you looking at, they're going to be okay.
Right.
You the one.
Right. Yeah.
You the one going to lose out.
Hallelujah.
Huh?
Amen, bitch.
What did I say? You got to fight for the rest of your life.
Yes. Right.
What did I say last week? You got to rock your faith.
Work, work. He said work. Got to work.
Work. You better work it.
Work.
Because the devil is fighting.
Yes.
Why? Because he know where he's going.
He knows.
But that rascal don't want to go there by himself.
Right.
Y'all hear what I said?
Amen. And he took a whole lot.
He don't want to go there by himself.
He's taking a whole lot. Y'all took a whole lot.
He's good too.
Yeah.
Let's go. Finish it up. Come on.
But be loved. Be not ignorant of this one thing.
Uh-oh. Now, Peter is telling the people. Huh? Uh-huh. Yeah, they say, where is he?
Yeah.
You've been saying that for a long time. Jesus is coming back. Where is he? Now, Peter tells them, be loved. Huh? Now, don't be ignorant.
Uh-huh. Come on, Bishop.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Man.
Peter's trying not to encourage the saints.
Yeah.
Because there evidently somebody was listening to him.
Uh-huh.
Huh? What did Peter say? Come on.
Lord Jesus, that one day is with the Lord as a thousand years. And a thousand years as one day.
Bring it up.
The Lord!
Wait. Just very quickly, what Peter is saying, you are concerned about time.
Time.
Time means nothing to God.
Amen.
You don't understand.
Huh?
Man.
God is eternal.
Right.
Huh?
Amen.
Y'all hear what I said?
Yes.
God is eternal.
Amen.
It means nothing with God.
Uh-huh. Nothing.
Huh?
Uh-huh. Right.
That's the case. Day like a thousand years like a day?
Yep.
Huh?
Nothing.
Read, come on.
The Lord is not slack. Concerning this
power. I love this.
Amen.
Peter lets them know God is not slow.
No.
Concerning his promise.
Right. Don't get it.
What promise? That Jesus is coming back.
Yeah.
Don't
get
it.
Huh?
Yep.
Huh?
Uh-huh.
Now Peter's telling me, yo, listen, let me turn it out. God is not slack.
Uh-huh.
Concerning his promise.
Yeah.
What? Huh?
Uh-huh.
Man. But what read?
Oh. As some men come slack.
Read.
What? But he's long suffering.
But God is long suffering.
Yeah.
Meaning God is patient.
Amen.
Why?
Wow.
Read.
To us, not willing that any should perish,
yeah,
but that all should come to repentance.
God,
man,
doesn't want anybody to go to hell.
No.
And therefore, what God is doing, he's giving us time.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Giving us time, y'all.
Huh?
You ought to clap your hands and thank God for the time that he's given us. The time that he's given our families. The time that he's given your children. Your friends. Even your enemies. Then Peter tells him, but let me remind you.
Amen.
And let me tell you,
Lord,
time is turn it out.
Lord,
read, Sister Johnson.
But the day of the Lord
read.
Will come as a thief in the night.
Read.
In which the head shall pass away.
Read.
With a great noise, and the elements shall melt with burning heat.
Read. Jesus is coming. that you saved.
Yeah.
Huh? God told me to help somebody. God told me to tell you I see you. You're back doing the things you said I brought you out.
Thank you.
person. Don't be greedy.
Okay.
But if you want to get more than one person, get, I told you the saints now. Get somebody that you love.
Yeah.
Huh?
Man.
You love to life.
Yeah.
That you know not saved.
Come on, God.
Oh, my Lord.
You might have taken five people. Although some of us do, we might get 100 people.
Yeah.
And I know.
Yeah.
That I know not saved. And when I think about what would happen, what would happen if Jesus came right now.
Yeah, not me.